So my name is Stacy Barthe, and I am a Haitian American singer-songwriter. So my mother was a 19-year-old immigrant when she came to this country, and she left because my father at the time was basically forging signatures of ambassadors and whoever to get people their visas to come to America. And my mom was one of the people that he was like, you can't have this kid here. And he fought like for me to come to America so that I could at least be born there. And if I had to come back, it was all good. But so after I was born in Brooklyn, I was sent back to Haiti. And I stayed there till I was probably in like the first grade. I used to get teased miserably because I was overweight, and you know, my mom didn't know how to comb my hair. It was giving very much doo-doo braid and socks with frills, and that's how I went to school. I was in a lot of like group activities, and not necessarily with people of color, you know, so they kind of embraced me differently than the African-American community, so to speak, you know. I definitely always wanted to be down. It was like, oh, that accent, oh, that, you know. So that was my experience growing up as an immigrant child, so to speak. Haiti has experienced as a whole since the beginning of freedom is, you know, beyond me. And people be like, oh, well, how is Haiti the first independent island? And then all this travesty is easy because that's what happens when you fight for freedom sometimes. Like, they somehow find a way to still oppress you. You know what I mean? And we, like, it's a third world country, so there's not much economy happening there. There's not much of anything happening to where, like, the people can actually thrive and get over that hump. So, I always think about how I can be of assistance. Like, how can I really help in a real way? And I'm still figuring it out, but I'm heartbroken over everything that's going on in Haiti.
Sometimes we say things that we really don't mean, but in the moment it seems like the thing to do. We're all flawed, beautiful people. We're all flawed, beautiful creatures. We're all flawed. To protect his own from harm's way, who are we to judge anyway? What would you have done if the gun was in your hand? Feet were in his shoes. Guess you'll never know what you won't do. Yeah. Cause in the moment, it might seem like the thing to do. Beautiful people. when you get the courage to be honest with yourself, then you can stop lying to everybody else, yeah. Don't you ever get tired of pretending tired. Ran so many miles that your legs gave out. You gotta ask yourself, what are you running from? Look at yourself in the mirror and say, hey, you there. Is it me you're looking for? Say, hey, you there. Is it me you're looking for? And while you're dying inside, you smile for everybody else. Don't you ever get tired of being uninspired? When you pour so much out and nothing in return, you gotta ask yourself, what are you fighting for? Face yourself in the mirror. Some time now, I've been searching for some time now, and I look myself in the eyes for the first time.
Heavy, 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 heavy.
dealing with things as if they don't affect you. Not here to judge you, I'm just reflecting you. I be reflecting you. And I got some issues I gotta deal with. End of the day, I won't take it out on you.
Bonsoir, Haitian Ladies Network. My name is Stacy Barthe, and I'm honored to be here with you guys tonight. I would like to introduce this next song. It's called Bon Dieu Bon, and as you all know, that means God is good. And regardless of whatever we go through, we're resilient people, and we always make it through. So this next song is called Bon Dieu Bon. Rock with me.
Producer Maestro played this beat for her. And she played down with that, oh, it's cool. And overlooked it, and I said, hey Maestro, I need you to tuck that for me. So after experiencing Tiwa in Lagos and how, like, she played a huge star there. You know what I mean? She started out as a songwriter out in America. And to see, like, the magnitude, she's like the Beyonce of Nigeria. You know, so it was amazing to see. Shortly after that, I went to Trinidad to sing for Marshall Montana's wedding. And I was super inspired by that. And I was in Jamaica, and then when I came back to New York, I still had that beat. And I went to my friend Jimmy's recording studio and I recorded Bon Dieu Bon. I'm trying to be the queen of the Caribbean. Look up, like. So this is like the first song that I wrote in Creole. And it came so fluidly and easily, and I was just like, wow, that you're awesome. So yeah, that's how that song came about.
Yeah.
envahi. Mais nous ensemble, nous couchons sous même cabane. Si c'est pour famille, c'est ça me besoin toute ma vie. Sorti.